course, WESH.com is a good source for all those weather warnings.
That's right. And Jason, people have this new tool on our website, the interactive radar, that can help.
Yeah, and it is cool. It's a very unique tool, guys. And I want to tell you, if there are storms out there, you can zoom right on in to your town, click on the storm, and if it's strong enough, it'll give you the track of the storm, exactly where it's going, when it's going to get there. It's a very neat tool, so check it out at WESH.com. Now, rain chances beginning to dry up, so you may not need to use this as we head on into the weekend. If you got outdoor plans, things are looking better. I want to show you what's going on here on our Viper Plus 24-hour rain total map. Some pretty good rain totals out there yesterday. You can see the coverage of rain running at about 30% there across central Florida. But for today, rain chances looking even less, only about 20%, and it's going to be from, say, Ocala down into Sumter County. More on that coming up. Let's get over to the temps, though, as you start the day out. We are in the mid-70s, guys. It's kind of a warm, muggy morning out there, and a hot afternoon expected once again. Temperatures running above normal toward the interior, with highs about 93 to 95 from Orlando, back up to Ocala, 89 to 90 for the early highs at the beaches before that easterly wind off the water can cool you on down well into the 80s as we go into the mid and late afternoon. Here's what's going on. High pressure in control, drying the air mass out. We've been watching this water vapor loop over the past couple of days if you've been following along with us. And that dry air is sitting up top, high pressure at the surface, kicks the sea breeze very quickly back along, say, the I-75 corridor. That's where you're going to have a chance to see a shower storm today. Late day, Ocala, Sumter County, and that's about it. So if you're heading to the beaches, we've got some pretty good weather for you here with low to mid-90s as we head in toward the start of the weekend. Rain chances running almost nil until at least early next week, and then things start to improve a bit with the wet season possibly making another appearance.